name is holy, let God make son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. For here in this love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. For all we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. For he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. For God hath committed all judgment unto the Son, in whom the Son set free is free indeed. And these are written that ye might believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing ye might have life through his name. For all flesh is his grass, and all the glory of man is the flower of the grass. The grass withereth, and the flower thereof falleth away, but the word of the Lord endureth forever. And this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you. Now that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that Christ was buried, and that Christ rose from the dead the third day according to the scriptures. For thus it is written, and thus it behoved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in this day upon all nations. For this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end that carriage held the truth. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Through which God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself, not imputing our trespasses unto us, for God had laid upon him the iniquity of us all. For God had made him, Jesus Christ, to be sin for us, to know no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who paid himself the prince of the world to be crucified in due time. For Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by him. But if any man come to Christ, Christ will in no wise cast him away. For if any man sin, we have an advocate with God, Jesus Christ, the righteous, who is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. For God is love, and God commended
his love for us,
and that while we were dead sinners, Christ died for us. Let him know him who can do this. Let a man lay down his life for his friends. Jesus Christ is himself. Bear our sins in his own body on the tree. Let me be to sin, let live unto righteousness. I will let me were ill, our life was wounded, our transgressions. Christ was hurt for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon Christ, and with his stripes are we healed. For if any man sin, we have an advocate with God, Jesus Christ, the righteous, who is the propitiation for our sins, and not for us only, but for the sins of the whole world. This is a painful thing, and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. be saved, and God is willing for all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thine house. For the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all would come to repentance. For except he repent, he shall all likewise perish. Repent ye therefore, and believe the gospel, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Now that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. For Jesus Christ thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, being in the very form of God. Jesus Christ made himself of no reputation, taking upon himself the form of a servant. Jesus Christ was made in the likeness of man, and being found in the very fashion as a man, Jesus Christ humbled himself unto obedience, even to the death of the cross. Wherefore God hath highly exalted him, and given to him a name which is above every name, and at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, of things in heaven, things on the earth, and things beneath the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. If the Son lest he be angry and ye perish from the way, when his wrath is kindled, but a little person are all they that put their trust in him. For he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. He is the God and live, for he shares your sin, will find you out. He not deceive God is an act whatsoever, an act so if that shall he also reap. He that soweth the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, and he that soweth the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap everlasting life. For it is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. And these words, they are spirit, and they are life. For heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word of the Lord shall be forever. And this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you, the gospel of Christ, which is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth. But be unto the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. For he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Hear ye God, and live, repent thee, and believe the gospel, for it is appointed unto men once died, but after this, the judgment, be sure your sin will find you out, for be not the seed, the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Yet God commendeth his love for us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now, and let us reason together, saith the Lord, though his sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though any head like crimson, they shall be as wool. For the Spirit and the bride say come. Let him that heareth say come. Whosoever is athirst, let him come. For whosoever will, let him take of water of life freely of faith, and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man which trusteth in him, for it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. But be on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. Jesus Christ the same, yesterday, today, and forever, that whatsoever ye shall ask in his name, that will he also do, that the Father shall be glorified in the Son. If he showeth anything in his name, he will do it. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life.
Hallelujah.
And
God
he that believeth not the Son shall not see
English?
Life.
French, you have French?
I don't have any French.
Okay.
And we are born again Christians.
Yeah, I understand. I really understand.
I believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. And that believing, he might have life from his day. Today is the day of salvation.
Are you speaking now?
Today, if ye hear his voice, harden not your hearts as in the provocation. For behold, there is the appointed time. Today is the day of salvation. But he on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved.